thine heart gather near. Come hither to my bedside. The hour that I must retire is drawing ever near. From the exigencies of this life, my deeds laid out before your eyes, and my conscience must be clear.
Charles, my dear son, the time has now come. The House of Arnulf had produced the heir and son to lead the faithless, where we are all waiting for you now, in the eternal kingdom, where we at last are one. Finally, you can look back upon your many great deeds, like your fathers before you have been planted the seeds. The consummation of your ancestors' ambitions, the founding of a great empire, a Christian nation.
Father, does my brother Carloman wait for me? And my mother Bertha, who with goodwill and diplomacy did all in her power to keep the peace. How was Aquitaine, the first uprising of my reign? I rammed those usurping traitors into the sea. Did I please our Lord Jesus when I united our peoples in his faith? The Saxons ever a plague on our lands, the Lombards that vile race. They would have desecrated his church and all that we hold dear. But I led them to redemption in Christ the Savior. O Father, this oath I swear, that I shall fight to keep the law in all of Francia and beyond, to heathen fields and Saxon hordes who would tread upon a sacred place of ours, shall learn to fear the name of Charlemagne, one that will be without peer even long after I have gone. Plotters turn your head against me. Our dear mother tried to foster harmony, but you were hungry for more influence and power. Why did you not listen to her? I forgive, for you were young, ambitious for your people, and your court was advising against me on principle. I see you now by the stream, playing with your little boots. Now as a prince on horseback, and then a king riding out across the moat. And then, oh father, now he is dead. How his widow and children weep by his bed. Now I am ruler of all your empire, and I am alone in the adventure that you came to me, father. I feel not on my own, and guided me on my sword, as sure as on my throne.
And now you're being besieged by the Saracen, but holding firm are the Christian kings of Spain.
The Frankish might push them back south, across the mountains to form the Spanish March. And what of the other pagan tribes who disrespected his holy see? They knelt before him and gave back that which they had taken from the holy city.
O Father, this oath I swear that I shall fight to keep the law in all of Francia and beyond. To heathen fields and Saxon hordes who would tread upon a sacred place of ours shall learn to fear the name of Charlemagne, one that will be without peer even long after I have gone. I might see the face of every one of those 4,000 heads which I had cut from the bodies of those Saxons who offended you, that they and I may be forgiven by your mercy.